So now in this error detection and correction technique, after discussing block coding and cyclic codes, now we will discuss checksum technique. So this checksum is an error detection technique that can be applied to messages of any length. In the internet, the checksum technique is mostly used at the network and transport layer rather than data link layer. To make our discussion of error detection technique complete, we need to discuss this checksum technique. So in this checksum technique, basically sender having a very high number of bit, we are dividing them into m bit frames. And then after adding those, after doing some steps, we are appending those m bit sequence with another m bit sequence. And that is basically our checksum. So basically we are adding message signal plus one m bit sequence, that is our checksum. And we are transmitting those full sequence message plus checksum through a transmission medium. And at the receiver side, we are again doing the checksum whether it is matching with the sender side or not. So basically, the idea of traditional checksum is very simple. To show it, we will see one example. So before discussing the example, basically you need to be clear that checksum is nothing but you are checking sum. At the sender side, checksum is created, and at the receiver side, checksum is validated. So while creating checksum, we need to follow certain rules. So you need to break your original message signal into blocks. And those blocks need to be same length. So either you can divide into blocks of 8 or 16 or 32. So after dividing it into a blocks, you need to do summation of all the blocks. And that summation need to be n bit. If it is exceeding, so whatever number of bits are exceeding, you need to take that one as a carry and you need to sum up that with the number of bits, that is n bits. And after doing all this calculation, you need to take one's complement. And that one's complement is basically your checksum, and you need to append your message signal with that checksum. The same thing is shown here. So basically you are dividing your message signal into n bits. And then you are doing the summation of those things. After doing the summation, you are taking one's complement. And whatever one's complement you are receiving, that will act as a checksum. And you are basically taking your message signal and appending it with your checksum, and you are transmitting it. At the receiver side, you are doing the summation of all the messages and checksum also. Because at the receiving end, you are dividing into n bit block, and you are taking all the summations of all the n bit blocks, and you are checking that this summation, whether all ones are there in that summation or not. If all ones are there, means you are accepting your whole data. Otherwise, you are rejecting that. So we will see the same thing with one example. So suppose this is your data, message signal. Now what I am doing is I am dividing this data into a length of or a block of 8 bit. So starting from here, I'm dividing this one into 8 bit. So after division of this data into 8 bit, we will receive this 4 blocks. Now before sending these 4 blocks, we need to find out what is the checksum. So to find out the checksum of these blocks, 8-bit blocks, basically, we will take those four blocks and we will do the summation. So if you do the summation, so here you can see that 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1, you will get 1. Here also it is same, that is 1. Here it is 1 plus 1 plus 0 plus 0, so 1 will be carry and you will receive 0. At this point also 1 plus 1 and other 0, 1 will be carry and at this point you will get 0. Here also you will get 0 and 1 carry. Here you will get 1 and 1 carry. Here you will get 0 and 1 carry. When you add 4 ones, your value will be 0 and carry will become 1-0. So basically you are adding those 8-bit blocks and you are getting 10-bit number here. So you need to add this exceeded portion at this point. So you are adding 1-0 again. So after adding this 1-0 again, you will get 1-0-1-0-0-1-0-0. So this is your overall addition. Now, what you need to do, you need to take 1's complement. So when you do 1's complement, this 0 will become 1, this 0 will become 1, this 1 will become 0, this 0 will become 1, this 0 will become 1, this 0, 1 will become 0, this 0 will become 1, this 1 will become 0. So overall, at the end, you are getting 1-1-0, 1-1-0, 1-0. And this is basically your checksum. So after getting your checksum, what sender will do, sender will send these blocks and append this 8 block, this extra block with this checksum. So basically, you are appending your data by this checksum. At the receiver end, when receiver receives all these data, basically it will collect, including checksum, and sum all the data blocks. And after doing the summation, if the result is 1 in all the places, then it will accept that data. Otherwise, it will reject that data. So suppose I am receiving the same data and checksum. Now at the receiver side, what it will do the summation of these 5 blocks, received 5 blocks. So if I do the summation of these 5 blocks, so I will get, this is 0, 0, 0, and only single one is there, 1. This is double 1, 0, 1 carry will be there. And this is 1, 1, 1, so 1 will be there and 1 carry will be there. This is 1, 1, 1, and 1 will be there, 1 carry will be there. Again, this is 1, 1, and 1, so 1 will be there, 1 carry will be there. Again, this is 1, 1, 1, so 1 will be there, 1 carry will be there. Again, this is 1, 1, 1, so 1 will be there, 1 carry will be there. And again, this is 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 5 times 1. So 1 will be there and 1, 0 will be carry. Again, you can see that you are adding blocks of 8-bit, but you are getting 10-bit here. So what I need to do, I need to add this one here. That is, I need to add 1, 0. So after doing this addition, you can see I'm getting 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 at all the places. If I'm getting 1, 1, 1, 1 at all the places, that means that whatever data I'm receiving is error free, and I can extract that checksum, that end 8-bit portion, and whatever remaining will be there, that is my message signal. So in this way, your checksum will evaluate whether there is any error or not. If I talk in terms of performance, the checksum detects all errors involving an odd number of bits. It detects most error involving an even number of bits also, The thing is, if one or more bit of a segment are damaged, and the corresponding bit or bits of opposite value in a second segment are also damaged, the sum of those columns will not change and the receiver will not detect error. So the main drawback is this only, that at the sender side and at the receiver side, if some damages are equal, then this checksum will not be able to detect whether any error is there or not. The most important thing is, this checksum can be applied to any data length. This is all about checksum.